evolution is a settled, scientific fact.
This is the rhetoric often espoused by the ardent evolutionist when in debate with a creationist. And of course, the evolutionist has to declare that evolution is a settled scientific fact, because any less of a declaration at least leaves room for the possibility of an intelligent designer, and or, blasphemies of all blasphemies, the Genesis account of the Bible and the Christian faith. But is evolution a settled scientific fact? While I am willing to admit that there are several scientifically factual observations noted by the field of evolutionary study, to declare the entire field of evolutionary theory to be a settled scientific fact to the exclusion of all other possibilities of origins and the continuation of the species is at least disingenuous and at most downright dishonest. It is generally a risky proposition to declare most anything a completely settled and scientific fact within the field of scientific knowledge and discovery, precisely because our knowledge base is forever expanding, and our paradigms of truth and understanding are forever being challenged and taken to new heights. A profound example of this problem is illustrated with the following example. For almost 2,000 years, it was considered settled scientific fact that one of the primary mechanisms for the origins of a living organism was through spontaneous generation, or life arising spontaneously from non-life. The great philosopher and scientist Aristotle proliferated this scientific fact of his day. So with animals, some spring from parent animals, according to their kind, whilst others grow spontaneously, and not from kindred stock. And of these instances of spontaneous generation, some come from putrefying earth or vegetable matter, as is the case with a number of insects, while others are spontaneously generated in the inside of animals, out of the secretions of their several organs. Animals and plants come into being in earth and in liquid, because there is water in earth and air in water, and in all air is vital heat, so that in a sense all things are full of soul. Therefore living things form quickly whenever this air and vital heat are enclosed in anything. When they are so enclosed, the corporeal liquids being heated, there arises, as it were, a frothy bubble. Aristotle is still considered one of the most significant founding figures in Western philosophy and science. Yet this astounding thinker and scientist was wrong on the matter of spontaneous generation. He was wrong concerning the fundamental question of life. And this is no small error. His massive miscalculation went to the foundation of life itself. Yet anyone who wished to argue for the spontaneous generation of life and the absence of a need for God could have appealed to the so-called settled scientific truth of Aristotle and his day. After all, Aristotle possessed a scientific mind of astounding proportions, and his postulation was taken for granted to be truth. Nevertheless, Aristotle was wrong. Over 200 years ago, Aristotle's declaration of life's origins through spontaneous generation was scientifically proven to be false. We now know, for a scientific fact, that life does not originate from non-life. And so what is evolution's story for the origins of life today, some 2,000 years after Aristotle? The answer is abiogenesis, or chemosynthesis. Fancy sounding words, but what do they mean? Plain and simple, the words mean this: life originated from non-living substances or non-living chemical compounds, randomly, without intelligent input or design. In other words, life originated through, wait for it, spontaneous generation. For anyone wishing to argue that origins theory is somehow not connected to evolution theory, we would simply refer you to any college textbook on origins, or specifically to Dr. Richard Dawkins' book, The Ancestor's Tale. In that book, Dawkins, the guru of modern evolution postulation, draws a distinct and unarguable connection between origins and the evolutionary process, touted today as settled scientific fact. So is origins and its subsequent explanation for the continuance of the life cycle, evolution, settled scientific fact? Not by a long shot. Not even close. In fact, some of the theory is still mired in 2,000-year-old mythology. A magic man in the mud, so to speak.